Brothers Grimm. By the side of a wood, in a country a long way off, ran a fine stream of water, and upon the stream there stood a mill. The miller's house was close by, and the miller, you must know, had a very beautiful daughter. She was, moreover, very shrewd and clever, and the miller was so proud of her that he one day told the king of the land, who used to come and hunt in the wood, that his daughter could spin gold out of straw. Now this king was very fond of money, and when he heard the miller's boast, his greediness was raised, and he sent for the girl to be brought before him. Then he led her to a chamber in his palace, where there was a great heap of straw, and gave her a spinning wheel, and said, "All this must be spun into gold before morning, as you love your life." It was in vain that the poor maiden said that it was only a silly boast of her father, for that she could do no such thing as spin straw. The chamber door was locked, and she was left alone. She sat down in one corner of the room, and began to bewail her hard fate, when on a sudden the door opened, and a droll-looking little man hobbled in and said, "Spin this straw into gold, and I know not how." "What will you give me," said the hobgoblin, "to do it for you?" "My necklace," replied the maiden. He took her at her word, and sat himself down to the wheel, and whistled. Shut up the poor miller's daughter again with a fresh task. Then she knew not what to do, and sat down once more to weep. But the dwarf soon opened the door and said, "What will you give me to do your task?" "The ring on my finger," said she. So her little friend took the ring and began to work at the wheel again, and whistled and sang, "Round about, lo and behold, reel away, straw into gold." as soon as she was alone, that dwarf came in and said, "What will you give me to spin gold for you this third time?" "I have nothing left," said she. "Then say you will give me," said the little man, "the first little child that you may have when you are queen." "That may never be," thought the miller's daughter, and as she knew no other way to get her task done, she said she would do what he asked. Round went the wheel again to the old song, and the mannikin once more spun the heap into gold. The king came in the morning, and, finding all he wanted, was forced to keep his word. So he married the miller's daughter, and she really became queen. She grieved sorely at her misfortune, and said she would give him all the wealth of the kingdom if he would let her off, but in vain, till at last her tears softened him, and he said, "I will give you 3 days' grace, and if during that time you tell me my name, you shall keep your child." Now the queen lay awake all night, thinking of all the odd names that she had ever heard, and she sent messengers all over the land to find out new ones. The next day, she began with Timothy, Ichabod, Benjamin, Jeremiah, and all the names she could remember. But to all and each of them he said, "Madam, that is not my name." The second day she began with all the comical names she could hear. Hunchback, Crookshanks, and so on. But the little gentleman still said to every one of them, "Madam, that is not my name." The third day, one of the messengers came back and said, "I have traveled 2 days without hearing of any other name. Yesterday, as I was climbing a high hill among the trees of the forest where the fox and the hare bid each other good night, I saw a little hut, and before the hut burnt a fire, and round about the fire a funny little dwarf was dancing singing, 'Merrily the feast I'll make, today I'll brew, tomorrow bake. Merrily I'll dance and sing, for next day will a stranger bring. Little does my lady dream, Rumpelstiltskin is my name.'" Joy, and as soon as her little she sat down upon her throne and called all her court round to enjoy the fun. And the nurse stood by her side with the baby in her arms, as if it was quite ready to be given up. Then the little man began to chuckle at the thought of having the poor child to take home with him to his hut in the woods. And he cried out, "Now, lady, what is my name? Is it John?"